Then here we have the placement tool. So by default, it will follow a curve. So we'll place models based on a curve. So you can, of course, start editing this. Then here at the top, we have, of course, parameters to control this. So we have different methods. So we have our curve and scatter on object. So by now, it will use curve. We can then here at the top control the spacing. So we can increase this to have more spacing between each model. Then we have certain options to set the rotation. So in here, we can have a target. We can, for example, set this to the x-axis. Then it will target along the line on the x-axis. We can also just set it to curve normal. And we can also adjust this here if you want to tweak some of the rotation. So we can get very custom. So we can get very specific in how the rotation should be handled. We can also do a twist. You can also do a partial twist and so on. Then further in the scale, we have some seat, but the seat is not working because we have to set the minimum and maximum distance. So let's say from minimum to maximum. We also can do scale along curve. So the top here is the smallest one and it will go bigger, bigger, bigger until the end. And we can still have some random seat in there if you want it. Then further, we have option here to scatter on object. So let's click on scatter an object. So it's not using the curve anymore, but we need to input a custom model over here. So I'm going to use that cylinder over here. So add a slot. And as you can see, we now have scattered these models on the cylinder. So let's go to settings. We can have a direction. So right now it's the y-axis, which basically means the up axis. And it will scatter props there. So we can also here get the density. So we can increase this density. And you can see how much actually we are adding. So if I would also increase this size, for example, you can see that we have a lot of these props there. And then we can also play around still with which direction you would like to see to have props scattered like this, for example. Then we also have options for rotation. So we can set some random rotation in there if you want that. And then play around with the seat. So you could, for example, plug in a grass model and then you can have quickly grass scattered around certain area. You can also here set certain scale, so we have some variation in the scales. Then finally, we can also set instancing. So of course, you probably want to use your own model. So in here, you're gonna go to assets and plug in your own model. So here I plugged in a prototype cube, and we can also see here that we have a new menu for instancing, which can then be used to further control more of the instancing.